Mooji. I wish to quote Mooji, who eloquently explains this very important truth, the fact that you are already the truth, that you are already enlightened. This is what he says. The light of understanding dispels the darkness that is already within you. There is a joy which arises when the light hits its mark and dispels the darkness of ignorance. It cannot give you the light because the light is already present within you. You are here. What more is there to say? Whatever you describe will only be another phenomenal thing. And we know that all phenomenal manifestations are impermanent by nature. Something inside of you knows not to pursue that. Don't get involved or stuck in any of that because it is not reliable. Moods are changing. Feelings are changing. Thoughts are changing. Identity is changing. Everything is changing. Everything just comes and goes. Has anything ever changed? No. It comes and goes, but when you have a particular fascination for a thing, it is as if you give it long levity. You give it life, which it doesn't naturally have. We impart life to it because that life arises from in your own aliveness, your own sentientness. It gives life or apparent life to even inanimate things, such as your power. It is largely unrecognized. We are still naive about ourselves. When you discover what actually is, your mind cannot argue with it. This is the purpose of staying with the what is. This is not a promise about the future. This is about showing you what is here now. The mind is the instrument of comparing, of measuring, of interpreting. But how can it evaluate that which is formless? Where is the location of that which is perceiving inside and out simultaneously? Where is its location? Mooji explains, that which goes out and comes back, which presently you are referring to you as yourself, is not yourself, it is your attention. It is the idea of who you are. It is your self-image that goes out and comes back. When it returns to you, it is happy, it is complete. When it goes out, an energy goes out with it. An energy goes with it, an identity goes with it. It has the power to create a second identity and reality. And that is what we are taking to be ourself. Your real self is that which is here. It looks like it is behind this secondary identity, the ego self. Your true self does not know behind or in front. It is so pure. It just is. Behind and in front happen in the realm of consciousness of the mind, the dynamic consciousness which is always changing. There is only consciousness. Even the ego is consciousness. However, it is consciousness which is severely limited by identifying with the limited body and obviously the limited consciousness. It is residing in a narrower or lower state of consciousness. Because of that, it embraces the limitation as a part of what is and believes that to be real. What gives the person the sense of reality? The feeling of reality is the vital force and the fact that consciousness is always there. This makes the ego feel real because it is also consciousness. Much of its reality is a construction of carefully or implemented elements. It is afraid of those elements because it cannot keep them to be permanent because they keep changing and dying. Every time something dies off, which is natural for that thing because the consciousness associates and identifies with that thing, it feels pain. Oh, this is going. It is dying. But it's only natural for it to go. You must find the thing that cannot go. Mooji then goes on to share with us how to get back in contact with our true self. He says, to understand anything in these teachings you don't understand, you have to go over and over it again until it awakens you. So that means if you come across something that confuses you, is complicated, or you can't figure out, then there's something there for you. There's some truth in it that's in a higher state of consciousness. And focus on it. Put your attention on it. Go over and over and over and over it again. I would suggest chant about it. Ask the divine to enlighten you about it. And you'll get it. It will just come to you. Truth will always come to you if you put your attention upon wanting to know it. So this is the purpose of learning the gentle touch, loving energy connection, because it will become a bridge between the limited mind and body and the pure truth of your core being. This will transform you by dissolving the limited understanding to awaken the inner eternal light of truth within your being. You will return home to your core. You will know when this happens because you feel a freedom like a space opening up. Then you've got it. You will know you've got it because you become so totally content, so totally present. Life becomes very sweet in this space of freedom from the conditioned and the limited personality. So I'm most grateful, Mooji. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed this.